Don, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron, how's it going?
Yeah.
If you want to know what the Cup fans are all about, pull out the old clip of Lee Elia having a tirade with the press.
Yeah, we got that earlier. This is one of my all-time favorite clips. And I was lucky enough to play Dream Week with Lee Elia, was one of the coaches. And he taught me the term drop mud from whenever you had to take a shit. Because he said, I missed that close play at third. I was dropping mud. During the fucking game, he goes in and takes the shit. Ilya spent some time with the Phils before that, though. So this is Lee Ilya. The Cubs fans, and this is when there was no night games. The Cubs fans were riding somebody because the Ilya gets off to a terrible fucking start managing this team one summer. And this is him at the press conference after the game.
I'll tell you one fucking thing. I hope we get fucking hotter than shit just to stuff it up them 3,000 fucking people that show up every fucking day. Because if they're the real Chicago fucking fans, they can kiss my fucking ass right downtown and print it. They're really, really behind you around here. My fucking ass. What the fuck am I supposed to do? Go out there and let my fucking players get destroyed every day and be quiet about it for the fucking nickel-dime people to show up? The motherfuckers don't even work. That's why they're out at the fucking game. They ought to go out and get a fucking job and find out what it's like to go out there and a fucking living. 85% of the fucking world's working. The other 15 come out here. The fucking playground for the cocksuckers. Rip them motherfuckers. Rip them cocksuckers like the fucking players. Got guys busting their fucking ass and them fucking people too. And that's the Cubs? My fucking ass. They talk about the great fucking support that the players get around here. I haven't seen it this fucking year. The name of the game is hit the ball, catch the ball, and get the fucking job done. Right now, we have more losses than we have wins. The fucking changes that have happened in the Cub organization are multifold. All right, they don't show because we're 5-14. And unfortunately, that's the criteria of them dumb 15 motherfucking percent that come out to day baseball. The other 85% are earning a living. It'll take more than a 5-13 or 5-14 to destroy the makeup of this club. I guarantee you that. There's some fucking pros out there that want to fucking play this game. But you're stuck in a fucking stigma of the fucking Dodgers and the Phillies and the Cardinals and all that cheap shit. All these motherfucking editorials about Say and fucking the Philly-itis and all that shit, it's sickening. It's unbelievable. It really is. It's a disheartening fucking situation we're in right now. 5-14 doesn't negate all that work. Got 143 fucking games left. What I'm trying to say is don't rip them fucking guys out there. Rip me. If you want to rip somebody, rip my fucking ass. But don't rip them fucking guys because they're giving everything they can give. But once we hit that fucking groove, it'll flow. And it will flow. The talent's there. I don't know how to make it any clearer to you. I'm frustrated. I'll guarantee I'm frustrated. It'd be different if I walked in this room every day at 8:30 and saw a bunch of guys that didn't give a shit. They give a shit, and it's a tough National League East. It's a tough National League, period.
He's the best. I love the fact it's not like someone's running a fucking vacuum cleaner. Rip him! Rip him for what they said! Just out of his fucking mind.
A vacuum cleaner or somebody blow drying the hair?
Oh, I hope not. That would really be bad.
I think it was the vacuum cleaner. All the reporters had just wandered away at that point, and he's still dropping F-bombs while someone's coming in to clean up.
And print it! He's fucking forcing them to print. You fucking fans suck.
Just furious at people who don't have jobs.
85% of the country's working. 50% are at the fucking ball game. That he's basically saying anyone who goes to war games has no job, has no life, has no purpose. Oh, God, Leo is fucking amazing.
Wasn't he fired not long after that?
Oh, he had to be. First of all, you can't understand people are pissed off at 5-14. You're 19 fucking games in. Lee, you got 5 wins.
That was 14 out of 19 games. And 3,000 people show up. You're lucky you got that.
Print it! Rip those fuckers! Rip them like they ripped us!
What was the part where he started just listing teams? Like, it's not like the Dodgers or the Phillies or any of that small-time shit.
Everybody,
what?
Everybody did it. They just recently lost them. Saying we've got Philly-itis. Because we can't beat those fuckers. Now listen to me. This whole thing's going to take time. We're going to turn this around. Just he'll get real positive for a second and then fucking beam off again. Just hysterical.
The sad part was he was absolutely right because the next year they won the East.
Yeah, without him.
Without him.
Without that fucker. He was doing some AAA ball down in goddamn Clearwater. We'll be right back, Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez, XM 202.
And the only prescription is more cowbell.
Outer space satellite blowing up nationwide. Boom goes the dynamite. Welcome to the Ron and Fez Show. Welcome to the Ron and Fez Show. Welcome to the Ron and Fez Show. Say what? Welcome to the Ron and Fez Show.
Yeah, it is the Ron and Fez Show. Wednesday. By the way, Fezzy, National Coming Out Day. If you're gay, today would be the day to tell your friends and family and be accepted.
I had no idea that was today.
Yes, Fez. So if you're gay, today is the day to tell your friends, your family, your listeners, and be accepted.
Right. People probably should that want to come out. Yeah.
Today's the day. If you want to, just say, Ron.
I understand today's the day.
Ron, Earl, Dave, I have something to announce, and then we will all accept you.
It's National Coming Out Day. I understand. You're really hammering that home.
I'm just saying, it's a good day if you want to say, I'm Fez Watley. I have a secret I've been holding inside. I can't believe you guys accept me. We will.
Now you're not even being discreet.
No, you're not. That's what I'm saying. Today's the day we don't be discreet.
Mark David Chapman, he was denied parole for the 4th time yesterday. The killer of John Lennon, they said that due to the bizarre nature of his crime, he has to stay in prison.
They find his crime a little weirder than other murders. How long has he been away now? 26 years?
Yeah.
Was it a 1980 murder?
1980, yep.
Yeah, he was convicted in 81, so, yeah, about 25 years.
25 years altogether. Thank you, Earl.
So he's eligible again in 2008. He'll try again.
Best of luck to you, Mark.
Just like John Kerry. He'll just try again in 2008.
Just give it another try.
See if he can get the votes.
Maybe just hope that music tastes change enough where people go, you know what, you had to write.
And now a Catty Moment with Fez.
Oh, say, Ronnie.
Did you come out?
No.
Oh, okay.
Did you hear Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie are friends again?
No, I didn't know about this.
Well, finally, TV's fakest feud since Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon is finally over. I heard that Paris and Nicole first got together for dinner. Paris eating it, Nicole puking it. With me there, Ronnie?
Shoulder to shoulder, Fez.
Paris ordered the ribs. Staring at Nicole must have given her a craving. This reunion's gonna be good for Paris in case she gets punched in the face again. It's nice having a friend shaped like a pool cue to hit someone with. And Nicole, she needs someone to help keep her on her feet. Literally. What a great story. The team of Boney and Cher are back together again.
That was a Catty Moment with Fez.
Well, there you have it. Fez came out and his friends accepted him.
No, that was a Catty Moment.
I'm just practicing for later in the show. I think I did it well.
There won't be any later in the show.
Well, Fezzy, you ripped them a new one there, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You took on those fat cats in Washington and showed them that the working man deserves respect.
No, it was Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie.
Well, what are they up to?
They're back together. They're friends again.
Oh.
And they're far from fat cats.
No, they're not.
They're like anorexic cats.
I knew nothing about them, but now I do.
The boniest hairless cat you can find.
And now a catty moment with Fez.
Oh, say, Ronnie.
Oh, yes, Fez.
Did you hear that Kathy Najimy is joining the show Numbers on CBS?
No, I didn't hear about that.
It's always a good move when you want to spice up a TV show. You add the fat, perky nun from Sister Act. That's just genius. With Big Kathy in the cast, I guess they're changing the name of the show to Round Numbers. She's going to play another math expert who counts everything but calories. Too true, Ronnie?
True that, Fezzy, true that.
In her first episode, it's a race against time to measure her circumference. Then there's the mystery of who's stealing lunch bags from the FBI kitchen fridge. Most shows eventually jump the shark. Looks like this one's jumping a killer whale.
That was a catty moment with Fez.
Who were you fighting with there, Fez?
That was Kathy Najimy.
I don't know her.
She's the big girl. She was a big nun in Sister Act with Whoopi Goldberg.
Never saw it.
And then she was the friend on Veronica's Closet starring Kirstie Alley.
Can't help you.
Till she outgrew Kirstie.
And now a catty moment with Fez.
I say, Ronnie.
Oh, yes, Fez.
Did you hear Katie Couric's CBS Evening News ratings continue to drop?
I didn't know that.
More people are now tuning into TBS Seinfeld reruns for their current events than Katie. Does CBS realize they could have gotten either Willard Scott or Gene Shalit from the Today Show, and it would have had the exact same impact? And a lot cheaper, too. Right, Ronnie?
Cheap as a white sale.
Katie, I don't know what you're going to do. Maybe uncrossing your legs for an accidentally on purpose muff shot while talking about Iraq might work. Wait, I think Charles Gibson tried that last week. Katie, you're going to have to come up with something new, which is hard for a woman who's already had a camera up her ass to build the numbers. I guess right now Dan Rather's career is laughing from the grave.
That was a catty moment with Fez.
Very nice, Fez.
Thank you. A little cattiness for you.
I love it. Do another one. Oh, yes, Fez.
Oh, I'm done.
You just do things in threes, huh?
Yeah.
Never fours or twos?
No, that would be gross.
Steve, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, I got to tell you, I can't get enough of those Frank the Frowner rants. I love them.
Yeah, Frank the Frowner. He always gets into something. Todd, you're on Run of Fez.
Ric Flair with a perfect Dirty Sanchez.
Do not woo that. That's catty moments, not Nature Boy.
Nature Boy. Don, you're in Run of Fez.
Ronnie.
Yeah.
Hey, you're going to have to double up your efforts on being a hero.
Yeah.
Fez come out today. He's that's a big hero step for Fezzy.
Congratulations.
I didn't come out of anything.
You know, there for a second, Fez, I thought I was going to beat you like we were in Wyoming. But then I remembered, I'll be a hero. A hero who accept his faggy friend for what he is. Even when that faggy friend is you.
There's a hero.
Me.
If you look inside your heart.
My heart.
You don't have to be afraid.
I'm not.
Of what you are.
I'm not afraid of being a hero.
There's an
a hero with a faggy sidekick that he totally accepts.
I don't need a hero, thank you.
Come on, pal. It's time we get you some cock. Let's go to one of those fag bars.
And then a hero comes along.
Me.
With the strength to carry on.
You're accepted.
I don't need to be accepted. Not coming out.
Call Dawn and tell her she doesn't have to do any more beard work. Today's the day. He's come out thanks to a hero.
Leave my girl out of this.
A hero that taught you, Fez, that you've got to accept someone. Yourself. Your faggy self.
Why whisper it?
This part should be in slow motion. Me and Fez just going to gay bars and me going, what about him? What about that guy?
We're not going to gay bars.
Go blow him. I accept you as your friend. You're doing it, Fez. You're able to accept yourself thanks to a hero. Hero of acceptance. With the strength to carry on. Chris, you're on Run Fez.
Hello?
Yes.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
I can't believe a bowl of gravy does such great impressions. I'm loving the new show. I really don't miss Fez at all, I gotta tell you.
Alright, I gotta send you the big ass prize closet for catching us. Fez hasn't been here all week. It's been me and a bowl of gravy. Took you guys almost two shows.
Do not reward bowl of gravy calls.
It's a hero and a gay bowl of gravy.
Gavy?
Listen to these fucking pipes this whore has. If I banged her in the ass, she'd hit six different octaves. Matt, you're on Run of Fez.
I just wanted to ask Fezzy a question.
Sure.
How did Dawn Cumia take it when you finally told her that you are gay, Fez?
I have not told Dawn Cumia that, Anthony's sister.
First, you gotta tell her you're a bowl of gravy.
Not confessing to be a condiment either.
Dan, you're on Run of Fez.
That is the best jam, Brady, since the gravy had a heart attack. Back to form, Fezzy.
You're back.
I'm back. It's me, but I'm not gravy, and I shouldn't even have to tell people that.
Because you're the middle one. And it's always Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. Chris, you're on Fez.
Hey, Fez, I want to say I'm very proud and accept you for being gay. Love
Thank you,
buddy.
It's a wonderful day for all of us. Cheyenne, you're on Fez.
Yeah, I'm going new school. XM 202. I just wanted to tell you, Ronnie, I miss old Fez in the closet.
There you go. You finally got to a joke. You worked out like you were spitting a hook out of your mouth, but you finally got to it. And he had a little joke there.
He was swimming upstream, but he made it.
But you were funnier than when you were in the closet.
I don't know what to say to that, because I'm not out of the closet.
You're still in the closet?
No, I didn't say that either.
Yeah.
You're trying to trick me with your lawyer's ways.
I don't know if that's what I have, is lawyer's ways. I'm not sure if I'd say that. He's the one with the lawyer's ways. Always trying to trick his friend in admitting that he's gay. Would you like to come out?
Of the closet?
Yes.
No.
Don't stay in there.
I'm not in. I can't come out if I'm not in. I would have to be in to come out.
Mm-hmm. Dan, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, Fezzy, did you just say that you don't use condoms? Because, you know, if you're banging a guy in the ass and you're not using condoms, bad thing.
Or even worse, he's banging you in your ass.
I didn't mention anything about condoms. Although I do believe birth control is usually the chick's responsibility.
So you tell the chick to put on a rubber before he fucks you in your ass?
Ass rubbers?
Hey, Bill, you're on Run of Fez.
29875.
Yeah, buddy.
Hoo-ah! Hoo-ah!
That was the best graviatorial I've ever heard.
Thank you. Here's Pete. Pete, you're on Run of Fez.
Fez is gay? What a bombshell!
Would you please accept him the way I do? And the way, Earl, what about you?
I fully accept him.
Even though that you're a black Methodist?
Rock? I'm a black Baptist. And
like, there's a difference.
You love the sinner, you hate the sin.
So you hate his sin?
That's what the Baptists always... That's their gay out whenever a gay relative comes out in a minister's family. He's like, well, we love the sinner, we hate the sin.
I always hate the saints.
They hate the cock. Love the fucking vagina. Why do they worry about that? Rick, you're on Run Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, God bless Fez, man. Thank God you came out. This was a great day to do it. Fez, got a question for you. Can I get Dawn's number?
Well, will she go back with Patrick, her real boyfriend?
You mean Fat Opie?
Hmm?
That's his nickname. That guy she used to see, Patrick, his nickname is Fat Opie. You know why?
Why's that?
He looks similar to Opie from ONA, but much, much heavier. Much, much heavier, Ronnie.
Yeah. No voice today, huh?
A lot.
Yeah. It's a whole new delivery. We never do the same delivery on the show. We need some catchphrases.
That would probably help.
Earl, what could your catchphrase be? I got one for you. Look at that, look at that. Every time you come in, it's look at that, look at that.
Let me try that. Look at that, look at that.
I like it.
Earl, it seems to work for you.
Dave, do you have a catchphrase on the show?
I'd like mine to be, I'm Eastside Dave. Everybody watch out. Just, it shows you who I am. You know, it's like, here he comes.
Yeah, I like it.
Thanks. I worked on that.
Fez, you want yours to be I'm a gravy bowl?
No, I don't. I'm not going to go with I'm a gravy bowl.
Yeah. Mine should be Ron Bennington. You missed me when I peaked. You should have seen me when I peaked. The Ron Bennington story.
Still better than gravy bowl.
Here's Matt. Matt, you're on Run Fez.
Yeah, the first catty moment was about a girl being too skinny. The second one was about a girl being too fat. I want to know what's just right for Fez.
Yeah, what is just right for you, Fez?
Then I guess I ended up with Katie Couric. Just right.
Perfect. You're like a little pixie.
A woman who has to have her studio photos airbrushed to take 25 pounds off of her.
Here's Brian. Brian, you're on Fez.
Hey, now that Fez is coming out of the closet, are you guys going to rename the channel Logo 202?
I like that.
Logo, I think, is taken.
Why?
I think that's a gay TV channel.
That'd be perfect.
I've heard.
We'll be the gay radio channel. A gay guy and his hero friend that accepts him.
I would think Go Low would probably be more appropriate than Logo.
How about Going to a Logo? Everybody. Here's Rob. Rob, you're on Run Fez.
276 checking in.
Cooah!
I got a good catchphrase for Dave. Not in the face, not in the face.
Wow, winning catchphrase.
The catchphrase for Dave, not in the face, not in the face.
Hold on, buddy. We'll get you one of those DVD copies of Scarface, the Platinum Edition, thanks to Universal Home Entertainment.
All right, Fezzy and I will give out a prize if we accept your catchphrase for the show. And we really could use some, Fez. I know she's still trying to work that Sia angle long after it's been toast.
Sia doesn't work. My Rude and Rude doesn't seem to have the same power it used to.
I don't know if that one ever worked for me. I never understood it.
Rude and Rude.
I got Rude, but why would it be Rude and Rude?
Because you're like twice as rude.
Where did you get it from?
It's like you were rude and then you came back and you were rude again.
Where did you steal that from?
I don't think I stole it from anywhere.
Starting to steal stuff. Because your stuff, your original stuff, doesn't even make sense. Earl, did the Rude and Rude ever make sense to you?
In certain spots it did, but more often than not it didn't.
Do you consider...
Well, look at that, look at that. He's agreeing with Ron.
866, Ron Zero Fez. Guess what joke I was going for.
Oh.
Pong! That's what we need. Sometimes we bump our heads on the way to a joke. Here's Rich. Rich, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, I want to know if Fezzi's church, Luther Vandross, is going to accept him coming out.
Will they, Fez? Would your church accept you for being gay?
I think my church accepts gay people.
Is that right?
Yeah, I think so. Because the one time I looked up a Lutheran church on where they stood on a bunch of things,
yeah,
there was so many things they said the church does not have an official stand on.
So you went to see how your church would feel if you came out of the closet.
I checked on birth control, capital punishment.
Interesting. My church is the church of the poison mind, and they're wide open for everything. Bob, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, what's happening?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, I got a catchphrase for Dave.
Yeah.
Ow, the fucking cowbell.
You know, you should have some other kind of catchphrase.
How about Eastside Dave's here? Get out the way.
I don't like that one. It's too herky-jerky.
Oh.
Robert, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ron. I got a new catchphrase for Earl.
Yeah.
Lordy, lordy.
How do you like lordy, lordy, Earl?
I do not like lordy, lordy.
How about lordy, lordy, look who's 40? And every time you come in with your birthday cake.
Earl's catchphrase should be...
Oh. How about I'm a co-ed ball player? I'm a co-ed ball player. Kurt, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
I got the perfect catchphrase for the show, guys.
Yeah.
Fuck Opie and Anthony.
XM202, Ron and Fez. XM202, Ron and Fez. Fuck Opie and Anthony.
Thank you, Adam. Thank you. Rob, you're on Ron and Fez. Lost your brother. Here's Steve. Steve, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Yeah, I got a perfect catchphrase for Dave.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you sure this is how you make rules, Dave?
I love it, Dave. Start going with that, no?
I don't really think it rolls off the tongue very well.
I'm sorry. I wanted to send you into the Big S Prize Closet.
Sometimes it does.
Scott, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Yeah.
Yeah, Fez, since you're coming out of the closet today, why don't you call Dawn Cumia, tell her everything you feel about her.
Who?
Dawn Cumia, Anthony's sister.
Oh, yeah. You had a fake relationship with her.
I have a very real relationship with her that I'm trying to get off the ground, and things like this just don't help it at all.
Congratulations, Patrick. I hope the two of you are very happy.
Oh, don't say that name to me.
Chris, you're Ron and Fez.
Fat Opie.
Hey, I love you guys. I got a catchphrase for Earl.
Yeah.
Febreze.
Summer Febreze. How about Taser Dad? Nah, that's just probably on my mind right now. Steve, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Yeah, Ronnie, I got a new song for the show for Black Girl. Don't trust that new nigga named Black Girl.
866 Ron Zero Fez. 866 Ron Zero Fez. Greg, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Yeah, I always like that saying Fezzy has. There's seven cocks in his ass, and there's always room for eight.
Why did you say that, Fez?
See, that wasn't me. That's Soundboard Fez. And I believe that was taken out of context and re-edited to sound like that.
What context would have even been in?
Oh, I'm sure one day I said seven, and I must have said there's no room for something, and there's seven dicks in my ass, and there's always room for eight.
Yeah, I don't hear anything, and that shows that there's an edit.
It's very choppy to me.
Tom, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, I got a catchphrase for Earl.
Yeah.
Ready? It's, Ron, I'm working on it as hard as I can.
That's not bad. Doing everything we can. Doing everything we can right now. Tony, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, I got one for Eastside Dave there, my favorite buddy pal.
Yeah.
This is Tony from Cleveland. Yeah, tell him it's Eastside Dave. You've now entered the bullshit zone.
You do lie quite a bit, Dave. You got caught six times today.
Everything I said was 90% accurate.
Thank you. Jason, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yogi.
Yeah, I got mine for you, Ronnie.
Yeah.
It'll be, man, I'm fucking starving.
866 Ron Zero Fez. 866 Ron Zero Fez. Rob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, boys, now that Fez is out of the closet, I'm going to miss his old beard from Niagara Falls, Ontario, Canada. It was so much more believable.
What happened there, Fez?
The Niagara Falls, Ontario, Canada fiancé? Mm-hmm. Ronnie, that was a ruse. I've admitted that to you on the air.
That's a lie?
That was a lie. I didn't have a fiancé.
Why did you say it?
I was trying to protect my personal life. I was trying to keep some things private and just not air every little undergarment of mine on the show.
Oh.
So that's where that came from.
7 years of lying?
Yeah, basically.
You feel better about it now?
That I've told you it was a lie? That there was no fiance? Yes, I do feel better about that.
When are you going to tell me the Dawn thing's a lie? I can't wait.
I will never tell you that, because I don't want it to. I don't want that thing to ever go away.
You don't want the truth ever to come out about that?
I don't want the relationship to end, is what I mean.
Garth, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Earl's phrase in memory of Leonard Skinner should be, they call me Febreze.
Here's Joel, you're on Ron and Fez.
I'm Eastside Dave, and I hate Chef.
866 Ron Zero Fez. Bill, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, I have a catchphrase for Fez.
Yeah, great.
New in town, Sailor? See ya.
I don't think that's new.
You've said that before?
I've never said it before, but I'm sure it's been said. I'm sure it's been said during Fleet Week, around Times Square.
Oh, is that where you clean yourself out? Fleet Week?
No, not the enema fleet.
Oh, I didn't know. I had no idea. When you say Fleet Week, I thought you were taking something up the ass for 7 days.
Don't always assume I mean enema when I'm talking about something.
Randy, you're on Run Fez.
Big S 307, buddy.
Oh, buddy.
I can't see. Move your balls.
Yeah.
This is for Eastside Dave. I get a paycheck?
Dave, you better not be.
No comment on that.
Do not cash it, because it's a mistake if you get one.
Gotta pay rent.
Chance, you're on Run Fez.
Yeah, I got a catchphrase for Eastside Dave.
Great.
I wish I was a chef so my girl would blow me.
It's a little wordy, but I think it's got potential.
Wordy? It's just perfect. David, you're on Run Fez. Lush to buddy. Hey, Earl, you were telling me that Eastside's chick was appalled with him last Friday.
Yeah, when he went out drinking after the show, and I went there, stopped in. You know, had a few with him. I had a few ginger ales with him.
Sure, GA.
And as we were leaving, he's like, he was just so inappropriate with me. He's like, I love you, man. He's hugging me. And she was just so horrified. I'm just like, it's like, and he's like, why won't you say you love me back? I'm like, Dave, your chick's here, and that's highly inappropriate. And she just stared daggers at you because you were just so horrifying.
Well, first of all, I don't really recall this. And this sounds very suspicious to me. Also, I think Earl, he's so sober. Sometimes he doesn't see what's going on.
Compared to you, yeah. But he's very sober.
Anyone who's had a drink in them, Earl thinks is automatically intoxicated.
I think anybody who starts to hug a black man and yell, I love you, why won't you tell me you love me back, in the middle of a restaurant, is probably had too much to drink.
I just was trying to give him nucks. I don't think I was trying to hug, and maybe I lost my balance and it slipped onto his shoulder.
Hey, what about this? Your catchphrase. I'm a piss-drunk Irish alcoholic.
I like that.
I can't envision that on, like, a T-shirt or anything.
Mark, you're on Fez.
I'm Fez Watley, and I'm going balls deep in Dawn Cumia. And
866, Ron Zero Fez. Ray, you're on Fez.
Hey, one for Earl is, I agree with you, Ron.
I love that. I want to tell you something else, Earl. Don't let these guys bust your balls. I think it takes a lot of balls for you to agree with me.
Absolutely agree with you, Ronnie.
Thank you
very much.
You're Robin to my Howard, my friend. You're Robin to my Howard.
Large black woman. So he's going to the big-ass prize closet, getting that Scarface Platinum Edition DVD today.
Michael, you're on Running Fez.
Yeah, I got a catchphrase for Earl.
Yeah.
Welcome to my XM studio apartment.
My XM studio apartment.
It really does have a studio in it.
He has a studio apartment on 57th Street, New York City. Literally.
I always know Earl's arrived because he always arrives every morning with some plastic bag with groceries every single morning.
What did he bring today?
Today I can go check.
Yeah,
can I go
ahead.
Find out?
I can tell you what I brought.
Go ahead, Earl.
I brought 2 cans of ginger ale.
G.A.
And was a Chef Boyardee ravioli.
Fucking starving. Jim, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, I got a catchphrase for your new partner, Sheepy.
What's
the
that?
Best there was, the best there is, the best there ever will be.
One thing about Sheepy is he is the excellence of execution.
I don't think Sheepy's so special.
When are we getting Sheepy back in here? The people love him.
I haven't heard from Sheepy in a while. He usually always likes to pop in and always emails me when he wants to come in.
What's going on there, Dave?
Here's his thing. You always hear this sound to all the listeners at home because he rumples his Dwayne Reed bags that he's probably had for a month with his Chef Boyardee. It's depressing as shit to just...
Yeah, you're writing me about my food. On at least 3 occasions, I will come into the office, and he'll be sitting there like a little kid who got caught with his hands in a cookie jar eating my crackers.
Why are you eating his crackers?
And a little thing of peanut butter was tucked away in the corner.
You bring your own peanut butter in?
No, I found it.
Because he doesn't have it.
I don't eat peanut butter, but he was like, and then I just turned and looked at him, and he was like, It's like, what are you doing? He's like, nothing at all.
You're like a rat storing away food.
Well, you come to me when you need crackers. I'll buy them for you.
I am very hungry. I don't eat breakfast, and I get hungry. He always has a case of like four things of saltines. Why not have five or six?
So just ask me. Don't just like a thief in the night. Just come in and grab them. Just ask me. I'm glad to give you crackers.
You know, Earl, when you were out with your white girlfriend the other day, I picked up the tab for you.
And I really appreciate it. You're my hero, Ron.
Dave is so disgusted hearing that.
He didn't know, but Mr. B, he probably didn't even take out his wallet or anything. You know,
that's not true. I had the credit card in my hand.
He flashed the credit card.
Bullshit.
I had a credit, like, I actually have a credit card, Dave, and I flashed the credit card.
You know why he did that?
Oh.
You know, I have a debit card, fine. It's not a real credit card.
It's not a credit card.
It says Visa on it. Big deal, Earl. But here's the main thing. If the chick wasn't there, there's no way Earl's taking out that credit card.
No,
the sad thing is, even the chick tried to chuck in some money.
No, I pulled out my credit card because I pay for what I bought, and I was going to pay
for it. You are the cheapest one here by far. Everyone
knows pay for what I buy, Dave. That is the God's honest truth.
I pay for what I buy in terms of good sandwiches, good foods, not Chef Boyardee. That's the signal.
But you're eating his crackers behind his back.
He has over 400 crackers stored back there.
No,
I can have eight.
Every time you go to a diner, steal some crackers for yourself.
No, you're like Mr. Moneybags. Why are you eating my food?
Because I'm sick of seeing the food, so I've decided to destroy your supply.
That doesn't even make sense. Brian, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, buddy. I'm Earl Douglas, and I will fuck a mental patient.
Yeah, that's a good one. You did that, Earl. You want that to be your new catchphrase?
No.
You're kind of ashamed of that, aren't you?
It's something, it's definitely one of the life lowlights, yes.
I know you didn't like it when I brought it in front of your new girlfriend the other night.
I told her.
That came up?
I go like this. So, are you a mental patient? And she's like, no. And I go, well, then how did you meet Earl?
With the hat, I just assumed.
Is she back in? Your old one?
Honestly, I don't know. I haven't heard
from her. She's getting electric shock.
I haven't heard anything in a couple of weeks. Electric, what?
You get fucking hard on if you hear the electric shock buzz?
No.
Brad, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
I got one for Eastside. Look who's cooking now. And I got one for you too, Ronnie. Real heroes return cell phones.
Thank you. I'm glad some people even remember the Herok thing. Here's the weird deal, though. How many times I've been out with Earl now for dinner at night, always a nice restaurant. I've asked you and your chick out now for like 10 months, never once did we go.
Well, I think one time we wanted to go, but you had other plans.
When was this?
This was a few months ago, and I don't know. It seems like, you know, she's busy, I'm busy. And
also, you make me uncomfortable when you're around her because you're always trying to shut her up.
Yes, I know.
You're like embarrassed. Have you ever noticed that? Like, she'll start to talk, and he'll be like, oh, no, he's just, don't even start with Mr. B. And he tries to push her down as we're making conversation. And he'll be like, you're talking crazy now.
He really does try to put her on the boards. Like, he won't let her order off a menu or something. He'll try to order for her, even if it's something she doesn't want, just so it's even less time that she's speaking.
Well, that is because she's very indecisive, and it takes her 15 minutes. She's like Earl in that, you know, how it takes him 15 minutes to order something off the menu. So that's just irritating. But you're right. I think she's going to spill some sort of weird shit that I do to you guys, and you know, who knows? I mean, my reputation is bad enough.
You try to shut her up every time that I see her. Every single time.
Yeah, I do. Yeah. Well, she has to be quiet, you know.
And what's so bad that it has to be hidden anyway? Because
I know. What are you doing that you're worried about her spilling? Oh, yes. Dave steals things from XM. What could she say?
Well, I mean, that's not far off.
I already know you're an idiot.
There's some things that, you know, could be illegal. I don't really want to go into it.
What are you doing that you're so worried about coming out?
I think one time she was going to tell you, you know, I took like a stapler or something. And as soon as I heard that,
I know what it is.
She was going
to. I know what it is. You're afraid she's going to say everyone should be nicer to Dave. Ron and Fez should be nicer to Dave. The
caller
should
be. You get down there and go like, those two assholes, I'm not going to put up with this much longer.
I don't say
the fucking white bank that talks to me. Believe me, on the street, I drop him. If I didn't need this money, I'd drop him on his ass right now.
No, I don't say that. But actually, now that I think about it, remember one time we were all outside, and she goes, oh, yeah, and Ron says, does he ever talk bad about the show? And she actually said, oh, yeah, occasionally he comes home and gripes about the show. And I was like, what the fuck? These are Ron, these are my bosses here. You can't tell them that.
Well, we got to be open. Dave, I can't change until I know what it is that makes you upset. I'd rather hear it from your girlfriend. And then maybe I'll make some changes.
Okay, there were welts on my arm from a cowbell. Maybe that's a couple things that we've discussed from time to time.
That's your character on the show.
Right, character. Yeah, I get it. But, you know, it's painful from time to time. That's all I'm saying.
So your thing is you don't want to be hit with a cowbell anymore.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that this is what we talk about.
All right, I'm going to just say to the listeners, the cowbell bit is over.
No.
I had no idea. I thought the welts reminded you of, oh, I work at a great job. Look at that welt. I got hit by an XM radio broadcaster. And maybe that would be, you know, a place for you to talk to people.
No, I'm not crying over spilled milk. All I do is...
It's grown cowbell, not spilt milk.
I talk to her.
You want me to start spilling milk on you?
No, I don't want that either. I talk to her, and... The way people release frustrations, that's all I do. But I'm afraid that she'll tell you guys that.
Here's Don. Don, you're on Run and Fez.
Yeah, I got a catchphrase for Dave.
Yeah.
Silent.
Nice. Wouldn't that be great? Dave, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, buddies, what's up? I've got a great catchphrase for Dave. It's your email box was open.
Yeah, because you look at people's emails.
Yeah, well, I'm curious.
And by people's, it's Earl's.
I have to see what he's doing.
And that's why you don't get to double date with him and his new girl. You're not part of that.
He will never take me anywhere. He'll never, you know, not unless I'm buying or I'm buying him.
Fezzy, you're not even doing the Notre Dame games with him anymore, are you?
No, we haven't done the Notre Dame games in a while.
How come?
Well, I got blown off a couple times. A couple times. And the last time he wanted to be drunk instead of hang out with me. So I just haven't done it.
Adam, you're on Run and Fez.
Come on, buddies. I got a catchphrase there for Dave. I have a fever, and my only prescription is more cowbell.
I could say that. I think it's already been taken.
Rich, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, Ron, I got a catchphrase for you.
Yeah.
I have to work with these idiots.
How does that make you guys feel?
That makes me feel bad.
How do you think I feel?
Worse.
Mm-hmm. Every day coming in here is like a nightmare. And I just go like this. Please, God, don't let anybody listen. Every day I think to myself, please don't let anyone listen to that show. Which is really not the thing that you want to do when you're in radio.
No, it should really be the opposite strategy. Please, God, let a lot of people listen.
See, I never think that way.
As many people as possible.
I go just the opposite. I want the fact that... One day, just to know that there's not one radio turned on. That would be my perfect day.
I don't think that would be helpful.
Why?
For anybody. Then they can't hear the show if the radios are turned off.
Right, and they can't hear my shame. The shame of what? A show that doesn't what?
Work?
Yes, a show that doesn't work.
Oh, I would
and producers that don't...
Work.
Produce. Oh. The only good thing that happened today is Fez came out of the closet.
I did not come out of the closet today.
Then that makes this the worst show ever. Scott, you're on Fez.
Catchphrase for Dave. At least I'm not hairy.
Here's Jay. Jay, you're on Fez. How are you?
Hey, this is Jay. Got one for Earl.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Earl Douglas, and the dinosaurs once roamed in my nose.
Remember that, Earl?
I'm not roaming my nose.
Here's Christopher Ann. Christopher Ann, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
How about what me worry for Dave as a catchphrase? And Fez,
yes?
When is the next listeners get together going to happen? Homo's what?
What?
I said, when is the next listeners get together going to happen?
I'm not sure when that's going to be. I have no idea if anything's playing.
You haven't chose a place yet? Homes what?
What? I don't understand what he's saying at the end.
You haven't thought of a place yet or talked to anybody?
No, not yet.
Because it's been a long time. Homes what?
What? What? Twice.
Twice the hobo.